Hello, hello, my lovely ladies. Welcome to a new episode in my Declutter series. I am going to dig into my eyeshadow palettes. It's that time. It's that time. I have my high-end and luxury brand eyeshadow palettes in front of me. I will do indie brands next, and then I will do the palettes I have from affordable brands like ColourPop, Drugstore, Morphe, stuff like that. So we are going to dig into all these palettes, and I'm going to show you which ones I am going to declutter and which ones I'm going to keep. If this is your first time here, then hi, welcome. My name is Anne Chris, and on my channel I want to inspire you to use a little bit of color every day by creating these fun, colorful looks, but also trying to keep them a little bit more elegant and a little less loud, so you can actually wear them every day. I also try out a lot of new makeup, especially from high-end and indie brands, as you will see, because the affordable pile is going to be the smallest. So if you need some inspiration on how to use color every day, but you also want to know what is really worth your time and money, then please consider subscribing and hit that notification bell, because I upload 2 to 3 times a week, so there's always something fun to watch. What I want to do, I'm going to start off with like the palettes I have, like one palette from one brand, and then I'm going into the palettes I have more from one brand, and so on and so on. I want to start off with my Pat McGrath Divine Rose. I think this is the Divine Rose 2, and it's in the Mothership 8. And the thing is, with this box, it's already broken. Not impressed. It is in this beautiful pink packaging, and you can see yourself sitting over there. Are you comfy? And this is the palette closed up. I do really like this palette. I did a video on it. I will link all the videos I did on these palettes down in the description box if I did a video on them. This palette is staying because it's really expensive. I do like it, but before you buy, please check that video out, because I have some thoughts. Then I have a palette from Lime Crime, and I was debating if this should be in the indie brand. So please let me know down below if you consider Lime Crime a indie brand. I just thought it's not a very cheap brand. I got it at Douglas, so I don't really know if it is a indie brand, yes or no. It is a very stunning palette. I do really love the color story. I have played with it a little bit. I didn't make a video on this one, but I do really love it, so it's staying. Then from Sigma, I have the Cordel Rosa palette. I got this palette this year. I really do enjoy it. I also got the Enchanted palette and the Untamed palette, but they're new, so I'm not going to put them in this declutter series, because obviously I'm going to keep those. But yeah, I really do love this color story. It's a very nice palette, so I'm totally keeping it. Then this palette from Pretty Vulgar, it's the Phoenix Rising palette. I think it is a very beautiful color story, and it really surprised me in like the quality. I am going to keep this. I was debating on it because I'm not really reaching for it a ton, but this is something I could take traveling very easily, and you could be like, you know, you can't travel. We will be able to travel in a few months' time. I hope. So I'm going to keep this. Then this little palette by Marc Jacobs. This is a very beautiful palette. I'm totally going to keep it. I bought this when I was in New York. I used it in my shop, my stash, not too long ago, and I really do enjoy it. This is one of the only palettes I actually keep the box, because I want to protect like this nice outer packaging. And I also keep this little slip because it's really luxe. Then this little palette from Charlotte Tilbury. This is the Easy Eye palette for the Charlotte Darling look. It's a very nice palette. You get this palette as a gift with purchase like everywhere now. So if you don't really want to buy it, then wait for just a sale on the Charlotte Tilbury side, or I think I saw on Cult Beauty or on Beautylish, I don't know for sure, but that this thing comes with a gift with purchase. So please don't buy it. Try and see if you can get it as a gift with purchase. I'm going to keep it. I really do love it. Then this next one by NARS, and I am debating if I'm going to keep it. The color story is really pretty, as you can see. It's really easy. I took it traveling with me when I went to Sweden. It's the Mojave palette, but I didn't really love the performance. When I first got this, I really liked the performance, but now I'm like, so I think I'm going to declutter this one. I'm going to put this to the side and declutter it. Maybe use it one more time, but I think I'm going to take this out of my collection. Then I have one palette from ABH Norvina, and this is also immediately the last palette I have like as from one brand, because I have a lot of Anastasia Beverly Hills, but I, you know, this is Norvina, just so I saw it as a different brand than from Anastasia. This is the color story, and it's so much fun. I use it a few times, and it's really nice. The shadows are a little bit drier like in the formula. but they perform really well and I did have a lot of fun playing with this palette. And this is a palette I can reach for as like a companion palette when I need certain shades. I did a like, what you call it, a halo eye with only matte shadows, and I put this one in the middle and it worked a charm. So stuff like that I do with this palette. This one is staying, but the box I'm going to throw away because I hate that. Okay, well, let's take a deep dive into my Anastasia Beverly Hills collection. I'm going to start off with the Modern Renaissance. And this is classic. Classic color story. It's very beautiful. It still performs really nicely. Even though I've had it for like 3 years, it's staying. Then the Norfina. Really beautiful color story as well. This is one I don't reach for that much. I do really like it. It's the purple palette. There's not that much purple in it, but I really do love the quality of the shades and I do love the tones of the shades. My all-time favorite, Subculture. Not a lot of people are a big fan of this one, but I do really love the color story. And yeah, the shades are a little finicky to work with, I know, but it's just one of my biggest loves. I love this one. Then the Soft Glam. This is, I think, a perfect color story for someone that loves to wear neutrals, that loves to wear like an easy eye look, but can vamp it up a little bit if you want to. This is something I would totally get my mom because it is such a nice color story. I think the Soft Glam, the little one, would be perfect for my mom. I was talking to her this morning and she was saying that she loved the Urban Decay Naked One palette. Discontinued. So I suggested she get this one or the small one. I might even send it over to her. I don't think she's watching, so it's fine. Then I think this is the oldest one, and this one is discontinued. This is the Prism. But because I am a little bit of a completionist when it comes to these Anastasia Beverly Hills palettes, I bought it on their website. I'm going to take the little brush out. I haven't even used this yet, so I really need to start using it. But I think the color story is perfect for this time of year, so I'm going to dig into it soon. Then the Riviera. And this is one I bought because I am that completionist, but then don't use as much. So I was debating if I should declutter it, but I just don't want to. I think it is really nice. The color story is really nice. There are some beautiful colors in here that I really do enjoy. And that is this like salmon-y color and this peachy color. I don't think it's in here, but I do really love this gold as well. It's very stunning. So I'm just keeping it for the holidays. And you can get it in a vault now. So I don't think you can get it separately, but you can get it in a vault. A lot of people say that this is like the same vibe as the Natasha Denona Glam palette. It has the same vibe. I don't know because I don't have the Glam palette. I will get it. And if you want to, if you want me to make a video on like comparing the two, then I totally will. But I think a lot of people already have. So I have three more to go, and they're all collab palettes. This is the one with Carly Bible, and this is one I think is totally underrated and didn't get enough time to shine. I used this in a shop my stash a few months back, and I really, really was impressed by the quality of this palette. So if you can get it on sale this like holiday season, then I would totally, totally suggest you get it. This is one I could have skipped because I already have the Riviera. As you can see, the color story is really bold. And it's, I do like it because, you know, I do really love colorful eyeshadows, but it's somehow not really inspiring to me. And the thing is, I should get rid of it then. I should get rid of it. You know what? I'm going to get rid of it. It is silly to want to hold on to it. I'm going to put a brush in there and I'm going to put that little flappy thingy back. And maybe I can give it away to someone. But this is, I don't use it. And I know I'm a bit of a completionist, but even that is not a healthy habit. So I'm going to declutter this. Whew. Wow. Second one. Big whoop. And then the last one from Anastasia Beverly Hills. It is the Checky Anna palette. And this is a stunning palette. I'm so glad I got this. This is perfect for the holidays. Perfect for New Year's. Perfect for Christmas. And winter, fall. Especially winter. This gives me really wintry vibes. With the red and the green. And like the deep sultry colors. I love this. And it performs beautifully. So this is a really, really nice one. And it's definitely staying. Then I'm going over into Natasha Denona. And I have this small, the mini gold palette. It is a really pretty, really cute color story. And this is one I take traveling a lot because it's so easy and it's really glam, but it's also, it has the green, it has the gold. You can do really fun looks with this, and it's just easy to chuck in your bag. And that is why I keep the box, because it's a little bit more protected that way. Then this is the Safari palette. This is a all matte palette, which I love because I love mattes. I do like shimmers, but mattes are my love. And I got this, I think, last holiday sale, I think. I don't think Black Friday, I think holiday sale. And I got this together with, I think, the sunset that's coming. Because I had like one, buy one, get one free, or both 50% off, I don't know. But I am so glad I got this. I used it a little bit, and I'm really glad I got this. I was debating on getting like a lot of Sydney Grace shadows this Black Friday sale, but I've already spent so much money that I was like, girl, you have a lot of the shades you were going to get in here, and you can pop them out, so you can make your own palette if I have to, if I want to. That is the reason why I buy a lot of single shadows as well, because I want to dupe out palettes that I might have bought otherwise. Then that same concept goes for the Biba palette. This is really nice. I think this is such a stunning color story. The only thing, there are three or four shimmery shades in here. They are okay. I'm just not blown away by the shimmer formula in this one. I do love the mattes, so it's staying. It's very like neutral for me, but I do love me a neutral look once in a while as well. Then the Natasha Denona gold palette, the big one. This palette I have wanted for such a long time before I got it. I think I bought this one when I was in London. I want to say at Harrods, but it also could be at Selfridges. I do like it, but I wasn't blown away by it. A lot of the gold have like a green tinge to it, and this shade disappears off the eyes so quickly. So yeah, I'm not going to declutter it by any means, but that is, was something I was a little bit disappointed with. Then I have the Natasha Denona Sunset palette. This color story is right up my alley. It is really warm, really nice. I do love the shimmer shades in this. Okay, I don't really like these type of shades. It's like a, yeah, it's too pinky. You see the shift? It's too pinky. It makes my eyes cry. I don't know. It makes me look like I have cry eyes, so I don't really love that. But I do love the formula. I do love the color story, so it is definitely staying. I don't know. I don't really love her shimmers. Then I have the Metropolis palette. This thing is on sale right now. I'm filming this during Black Friday, so I think it will still be available during holiday. And this was limited edition, mind you. I must say, with this palette, I do really like the quality. The thing is, it does perform a little differently than the other palettes I showed you. And the reason for that is because there's a lot of different formulas in here. So there's like cream to powder, there's powders, but there's also different types of shimmers. You have to work a little bit harder to make these shades really blend out on your eyes, especially the cream to powder shades. But the results they give you, stunning, and they stay on the eyes the whole day. So that is something that I was like, okay, it works a little bit differently, but the effect is so beautiful and different than any type of other shades I have in my collection. So if this color story is really appealing to you, then please do and try and get it on sale. Then I have a Huda Beauty Mint palette. This is the pastel mint, yeah, the pastel mint palette by Huda Beauty. Look at this color story. It is so dang cute, but the quality? Oh my god, it's so bad, so bad. The only shades I really liked were this one and this one. The rest, I didn't even film with this palette. I tried to, but it was such a train wreck that I'm like, no. I will get these shades from any other indie brand and I'm done. This is leaving my collection. Bye bye. Then the other palette I have from Huda is the new nude palette. And this one I really do like. But if I'm really honest, the only shades I really like are those speckled like shimmer shades. I've swatched them on my hand. Look at this. Oh, they're so buttery. So the thing is, I would love to declutter this because I don't use it. I never reach for it, but these keep me from doing that. But coming coming to think of it, if I look at these two, I think I can dupe these quite easily with the Pat McGrath Divine Rose. This one is too peachy pinky for my eyes. I never use these types of shades. And this is the only one I think is kind of special. I'm saying bye-bye to this thing. Because I never use it. I can dupe out the shades that are really special. And I don't even think I like Huda that much. So, bye. I'm going over into Urban Decay. I don't have a lot, but I have a few. I got this Naked Honey. This is the color story. I loved it the moment I saw it because it's so nice. These browns are so beautiful. But because they are a little bit more murky, they're really different from the rest I have in my collection. I am not the biggest fan of the shimmer shades from Urban Decay. So I'm like, nah, on those. But this is a really nice palette. I really want to keep it. So it's staying. Then I have the Naked Reloaded palette. This is a palette that came out because they discontinued the Naked one, or at least we think so, because it's Naked Reloaded. And I must say, when I first got this, I really liked it. I really liked this like packaging. It's really nice. It feels really luxe. The orchids are stunning. But the trouble is, the shimmers died on me. They don't show up anymore. Well, and this is the other one. I'm not a Vulcan, I can't put them down. But yeah, no. I used this palette a few, I know, I don't want to say weeks, I want to say months ago. And I was like, am I going to hang on to this? No, it's going. Then one of my favorite palettes in my collection, one of my favorite palettes in my collection is the Urban Decay Born to Run palette. I did when I was still doing those, I did a 1 month one palette on with this palette, and it's really nice. It is not extremely versatile, not as much as I thought, but it is really nice and I'm definitely keeping it. And because I'm not that attached to it anymore, I can take this traveling easily and not be afraid that it's going to shatter. So yeah, I really do like it. And then the last one is this big beast. I got this when I was on my honeymoon in Cornwall last year. It was last year. And I must say, I put this palette in my Shop My Stash and I did use it a lot. I just never filmed the Shop My Stash. I do like it. It's a nice palette, but I am someone who loves mattes. And I have, I think in total, 3 mattes. And I have 20 shades in this palette, and only 3 are mattes. And it's not like the shimmers are great. They are okay. They're nice, but they're not great. I'm just going to hold on to this because, you know, it's Game of Thrones. I'm sorry. I'm a geek. I'm a nerd. You may not expect that of me, but I am a nerd. Look at this. I think this is the coolest thing ever out of the whole palette. Woo. How cool. So I'm going to hold on to this just for my geeky self. Then I'm going over into MAC because I have 3 9 pen palettes from MAC. Oh, there was a little thingy in there. Okay. This one I penned, I think, is it 1 year ago, 2 years ago? I put it in a Project Pen project. And it's nice. It's just getting really old. So I'm going to get rid of it now. And I think it is called the Semi-Sweet Times 9. Yeah. You don't even want to know how many times I forgot what this thing was called when I was filming those Project Pen videos. It was hilarious. Then I have another one. This is a 9 pen palette. And this is also a little thingy. This is the Solar Glow Times 9. I took this traveling this summer because I wanted to see if I like it and if I want to use it. And I don't really like it. So I'm going to get rid of this one. And I am not going to fall for these cutesy 9 pen palettes by MAC again, because I just don't really like them. And then I have another one. And this is the one in the Soul, the Boom Boom Bloom. Soul Blooming I wanted to say, but that's nabla. The Boom Boom Bloom collection. This palette my makeup artist used for my wedding. Not this one, but the one she had. So this one is staying in my collection because I have sentimental reasons. But yeah, otherwise I probably would have chucked this one as well. Because it's nice, but it's not... It's beige. It's very beige. It's not even pink. It's beige. Oh, and I have one palette. Well, technically, it's not really a palette. It's a quad. It's by Chanel. And I'm not going to get rid of this. It's this one. It's so beautiful. I got this not that long ago. It's the Lala Candeur. Candeur. I don't know. Et Seduction. Seduction. No, I'm not French. I'm sorry. But it's a very stunning palette. I did a video on this one, so I will link that. Beautiful. And then the last brand. I'm sorry if this took long, but you know, these type of videos always tend to take long. I have some Viseart palettes. This is the Warm Edit palette. It is so beautiful. And for me, the perfect color story. So I take this traveling, I think, every time. Every time I go away, I put this in my bag. Then I have this small one. This is the Apricotine. It is in their Petit Pro line. This is the color story. It's very complementary to the Warm Edit. It's just a little bit more peachy and a little lighter. So I really do love this. I do take a traveling when I go away in summer. Then I have the Theory palette. This is really beautiful as well. Also a very big favorite when I go traveling, especially when I go traveling in winter, because I think this is a really nice color story for winter. And then the last one is the Petit Pro 3. Also a perfect traveling companion in fall and winter, as you can see by the shades. So these, all of them, I really love. And I think I'm going to just keep on building on that collection, because I really do love Viseart. I do love the quality. I do love the color stories. And yeah, it's nice to have these like very small ones to take on a holiday. You can even switch out the shades. You can, you have these little like nook, so you can take them out. It's really handy, so I really do love them. Okay, let's wrap this up and see how much I'm decluttering. I don't think it's a lot, but I didn't expect I would. I'm decluttering these 7. It is not a great declutter, I know, but I really do love my high-end palette. So yeah, I didn't think I was going to get rid of a lot. I think I'm going to get rid of a lot when it comes to the affordable ones. I think that is going to be the very big one. Okay, ladies, thank you so much for watching. Please consider subscribing, because I have and Christmas going on, and I have a video almost every day. So please consider subscribing, because there are a lot more declutters coming. There were a lot more declutters before this video. So go check out that playlist. I will have a playlist for my declutters down in the description box and somewhere on my like channel page. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you liked what you saw. Please give this video a thumbs up. I hope I will see you in my next one. Bye.